Eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
Which planter do I use? I don't know. I just made that up. We have had major problems since 3 weeks ago. I made a video about cover crops and how hard it is going to be to plant into it. But I'm not really worried about the cover crops right now. For the most part, I'm more worried about the weather. We have had extremely wet conditions ever since I made that video. I was actually hoping to plant, and I have planted some, but I haven't planted a lot since then. I planted right at 90 acres, which is not very much, and I've actually had some major problems since I planted it. The soybeans came up a little bit in places they didn't do very good. And I noticed a lot of seeds that rotted underground, and you don't want that. But we just have had extremes amount of rain. As you can see here, this is all knocked down cover crop because I was testing out the air seeder that I have not had in the game for about 3 years since the last time I planted wheat, since I upgraded to the Kinze 3605 bulk fill planter. I have not used the air seeder. But what I have noticed in this cover crop, and actually this cover crop, this is actually cereal rye. This is not very thick and very tall like some of it. But what I noticed, as you can see, I've already planted this and it's still standing pretty high. It didn't get knocked down at all. And there are beans coming up. Not too bad. These actually look really good. But I want to find an option here to be able to knock down the beans a little, or the cereal rye a little bit better, to lay down a better mat. And I tested out the air seeder yesterday and it did a perfect job. I'll just show you. So right now I'm walking in where I planted with a planter, and it didn't knock down a lot, except for maybe where the tires went, as you can see. And well, there's some deer damage right here. You can see where they nipped it off. They like to go down the rows. As you can see, that one's been nipped off. There's a bean that doesn't look like it's nipped off, but it don't look too healthy. There's one nipped off. They just like to walk down these rows. Oh, there's one there. And just chew these soybeans up. Gotta love deer. So I tested out the air seeder yesterday and it did a fantastic job of knocking down the cereal rye that's already there and standing. Here's what I'm talking about. So I actually air seeded this yesterday just to test it out. And you can tell it's laid it down almost flat on the ground, just like a roller would. There's a few spots here and there, maybe one there, here, where it didn't do the greatest job, but look at the difference. So I am going to switch for now to the air seeder to help knock down some more of this cereal rye. The problem is, from what I have been told, is that, and some of my experiences, like if you don't knock this down, this is like a rainforest, or a forest rather. Feels like a rainforest as much as this rain. What these beans will actually do is, if you don't knock it down, they're gonna put all their energy into growing up to get the sunlight, because we have all these plants here towering above it. So they're gonna spend a lot of their energy growing up, and that is a problem, because growing up does not put on soybeans when the time comes. We don't want that. We want soybean seed. Oh, here's more deer damage. If you farm soybeans or plant soybeans for crop and you have deer, you're gonna have problems. You hear that sound? Cicadas. Those things are loud, loud, loud. They act like it's like every 200 years we get this kind of a hatch. It's pretty amazing how loud they are getting. I bet all the animals and turkeys and wildlife are enjoying it, eating them. So yeah, the air seeder, the planter, those were my two options, only options really. And I'm gonna go with the air seeder. So we're gonna start up again, planting, and see what happens. Stay tuned, and we'll see if we can get a little bit more done. But I have actually debated this, because if you look, the soil is not 100% ready. The way I test it, easiest way is to stick a knife in the ground or get you a piece of dirt. And if you can make a ball out of it, which is what I'm doing right now, it's too wet. But what I'm gonna try to do, we actually have more rain coming tomorrow, the next day, the next day, the next day, for like another week. I am gonna leave the seed trench open. So what it does is it cuts a line there, and it's supposed to drop the seed and then come back and close the trench. Well, here's an example. This is what I did yesterday. Now, this is a little bit too extreme. This is because when I turned, it did not plant very good. But what's going to happen is when it rains, this is all going to get crushed down in there if it's a good hard rain. And these beans will actually come up. What I like to see is a little bit deeper trench and then seed, like right here, especially when it's wet. Some people would say that that's not good at all, but that will actually come up when we get the rain. And we're getting rain. The way it's been going, we're getting rain. We are the opposite of some people. I know I watch some other people on different channels, and they are having serious drought, like up in Canada. Mike Mitchell, for example, I like watching him. He's having serious drought. I wish I could send him some of our rain and he could send us a little bit of dry weather. This is what you want to see. The seed is like a half inch deep and not really covered up. Now, if it was dry like it is here, this is kind of dry, I would want the seed trench to be covered. But since it's not dry, what will happen, and if I was to close this, it would almost smash it too tight and it would not come up. And that's what we have going on in some places in this field. The beans just rotted. So like right here, there's supposed to be a bean about every 3 inches. Some of these are deer damage. Some of it, it looks like a lot of deer damage. But there's supposed to be a bean every 3 inches because they're on 15-inch rows. Well, there's not even a bean for a foot and a half there. There's not even a bean for 4 feet there. So that's the problems I've got. I'm trying to come back here and spot plant the bad spots. And it's not great, I can tell you that. So let's get back to drilling, planting. I was spraying, but it's dried out enough now. I think I'm gonna try it. So yeah, stay tuned. Living a dream. All right, here we go. This is a 1990 John Deere air seeder. That's the model number. So here we go, let's see what happens. Again, this is a replant. This is what I'm doing. I've got to watch this meter here. I'm wanting to shoot for about 150,000 seeds per acre. That's kind of what I'm thinking. And right now we're at 210.
pot. But I want to see how it does as we go. I also took pressure off of half the side of the closing wheels just to see if it's going to make a difference as far as closing. I'm in the John Deere 8400 right now. See, it's dropped down to 170, 160. But look how it's laying that down. I mean, it's laying it down perfectly. I thought I was going to need to buy a roller the other day just to drill in this and knock it down a little bit or plant in it. I'm glad I tested out the air seeder. We're still planting a little high, so I'm going to adjust the rate, which is this button right here. See if that changes. The reason why I'm stopping is there a tree here. You can see it. Fell out into the field. So I'm going to raise it up. And actually, I'm going to go back here and look. And see how things are. You'll be able to see what I'm talking about. So like right here, there's no soybeans. Well, there's one here. One plant there. None up here. Oh, here's deer damage. Deer damage, deer damage. Nothing here, deer damage. I've got more of a problem with deer damage than I have anything else. So I didn't want to run over this big mess. So this ground is on the edge of being dry, but not too dry. See, that's perfect for the rain that we have coming. I would not do that any other time, but if this ground it's too wet to be closing the seed trench. Place it to some, it is closed. So this side here is completely no pressure on it. And when I talk about no pressure, sorry, this is really loud. These right here, they're just weighted. Just the weight of it now is pushing down. And you adjust it right here. Well, there's actually just a little bit maybe. It was all the way up. If anything, I can maybe lower the depth a little bit, but that's honestly, that's what I want. There's this bean seed really close to a half inch deep. When it rains, it will close this. But if I were to close it right now, really tight on some of this ground, actually this ground's drier than most, but if I was to close this really tight, that seed would probably rot, especially if we get a lot of rain, and it would not come through there. Now, I'm telling you what, I've got a lot of soybean damage from here. So I did not change the center sections at all as far as the pressure. See right here, it's pushing that one pretty tight. That was pushed tight. That was tight. In this kind of ground, it's good. In wet ground, again, like I said, it's not good. All right, I'm gonna keep going. Probably do a little bit of changing on the center section because it looks like it's putting a little bit too much pressure on it. So anyhow, let me drink.